on a man winner. Prizefighter, Great Tipton Promotions, here, live at the Premier Suite, Bar Sports Cannon. Delman Promotions, Fightnight Line TV, Association with Great Tipton Promotions, proudly presents your Prizefighter boxing here this evening. Welcome, firstly, into the ring, our first contender, Alex Cox. And the Premier Suite Bar Sports in Cannon. Your official sponsors, V2 in Electrical Services from Smithy Cottage. Thank you very much for sponsoring this evening's Banks Are Boxing. Here we go with our first fighters of the evening. Introducing firstly, in the red corner, wearing black shorts, white trim and white bunting.
Our first quarter-final in this, Craig Tipton Promotions, 8-man prize fighter, Alex Cox in the red corner, Zoltan Titan in the blue. Eight men, one winner, £1,000, winner takes all. And here's our first quarter-final. The southpaw Alex Cox with the white trim to his black shorts against Zoltan Titan. And Cox already coming in hard and fast with these hooking punches to body and head. Titan tucks up and then fires back. What an opening. Oh, and the right hand lands. Cox calls Titan on, but Titan threw that big right hand. And the thinking here is potentially three bouts in one night, get your opponent out of there early. And that's what both these men are looking to do in this opening round. That's what makes Prizefighter tournament so exciting. Tight, hard shots here from Cox with these hooks. Titan, that tight guard look, comes out with the right, misses with the left hook. Cox teeing up that left hand, slips the reply, right uppercut, right to the body, around the elbow. Now Titan looks for his own hooks to body and head. Cox, little shots there, just setting his man up, you know, for the big shot, possibly the hook to the body. And it's Titan's gum shield, I think, out. Or is it Cox's? It's Cox's gum shield there. He gets it back in. He touched gloves sportingly. Titan pushes forward. Cox looks for the uppercut, looks for it again, lands it. Well, three, four, five uppercuts here. Titan keeping that guard tight with those elbows tucked in, and he needed it there. Looks for his own big right hook. Cox, very confident there, stood in the pocket in front of Titan, switches to orthodox stance to land the uppercut, but Titan comes back with his hooking shots. That's a big right from Cox, and Titan, suddenly his legs wobble. The big right hook switched from southpaw to orthodox Cox, and it paid dividends right at the end of the round. Landed the big right hook. Titan, his legs went for a short second there, but he recovered well. Good opening round for both men. I've got Cox ahead on my scorecard. So round two. They touch gloves. Back to southpaw for Cox. Nice lateral movement as Zoltan Titan came forward. Switches to orthodox again, Cox. I think looking to mess with Titan's head here. So he doesn't know when that right's coming and from what angle. It worked beautifully at the end of the first, landing a right hook flush. And that left uppercut this time to the head. Zoltan's got a good chin. And Zoltan Titan comes forward with his own hooks now. Cox backed up to the ropes. And he's looking for those uppercuts again, but he keeps a tight guard, Titan. He learned from that opening round. Look at those elbows tucked together. And then switches the angles. Cox to look to work the body behind the elbow. He's saying the groin there. Harvey Harris saying, no, that came in clean. So Titan looks for these big hooks himself as he comes forward. Left and right as he comes in. Tucks up tight again. Cox, calm and controlled, arms down. But as he does so, he's clipped with both the left and the right there, so he's got to be careful. You can't be overconfident when one big hook could end this and your chance of £1,000. That's what this prize fighter is all about. Eight-man start, one man takes home the prize. And you can hear them shouting in the corner saying, Coxie, set those shots up. And there's that uppercut again, lands cleanly. The nose bleeding now for Titan. He's had his moments, but Cox is in control of this bout as it stands. Last 10 seconds of the second round. Titan looked for the big right hand. Cox saw it coming this time. Leaning in, Titan. Cox just slips away and throws the punches. I got him two rounds for the good. For me, Titan needs a KO to take this bout and move to the semi-final. Third and final round. I've got Cox two rounds to the good. Titan looks for the big right hook. That's what he needs, one of those to land cleanly to go through to the next round. Warned about his head because he does come forward with the head. He leans low. But that's what he's looking for as he does so. Those big hooks when Cox brings his guard down to throw his own hooking punches. Nice movement, just steps away, Cox. Now those little punches again, just keeping that guard tight. Then he slips and looks to come around it. There he goes again. He moves laterally to the left or right once. He's got Titan covering his eyes with his gloves. Little shifts of movement there from Cox that sets up the right to the body. There's a bit of showboat for Titan. Says, come on, bring it on. It doesn't hurt. He's a gutsy, tough campaigner. And Cox caught with that right. Doesn't trouble him, but he's got to be careful. We saw in our opening novice heavyweight bout that one shot could turn about on its head, as it did in favour of Anthony Worthington with that huge uppercut. It can happen here, even when you're in control of the bout. And again, little clip with the left there from Titan. It just doesn't carry the weight now, here late in the bout. But he's been gutsy. He's still coming forward, nose bleeding, looking to throw the big hooks. Cox just working behind the jab, conserving energy. He might have two more bouts here yet. Titan pushing forward. He needs a big round. He knows it. And to be fair to him, to his credit, he's looked to get these shots. There you go. That left hook landed, and Cox felt that. That's what chance you take when you drop the guard and you're overconfident. Titan landed with that left hook. Now, Cox took it well. Big, big finish from Titan. For me, Cox is going to take the bout, but Titan really went for it in the third. Yes, Cox moves on. Titan, a big third round, but Cox had two rounds in the bag. Excellent opening bout in this prize fighter.
Please welcome Dean.
So our second quarter-final seeds, Dean McGann in the red corner, Jay Reedy in the blue. Final instructions from our referee, Harvey Harra. I've seen Jay Reedy in the white shorts on the circuit a number of occasions. He's a good front foot boxer, all action style. So this could be a cracking quarter-final. And there's Reedy coming forward, straight right, left hook. Starts to throw the body hooks. McGann tucks up, comes firing back. Already these two men have planted their feet, throwing the big shots. Stiff jab from McGann, stiff jab from Reedy. Two good boxers in this ring. And already they've shown us they're expecting to give us fireworks here. Left hook from Reedy, just off target, but look at McGann backing him up now, throwing the right hooks. These two men taking the prize fighter on board. Get them out early, get through to the next round. Good movement here from both men. Tight in the corner, trading hooks. And now McGann pushing forward, looking to force Reedy back. Leaning into him, throws the left hook. Reedy throws back, McGann looking to back him up again. Oh, and as he did so, as he backed him up, watch this, it's a right uppercut and a left hook, both find the target. There's the uppercut, there's the hook, and Reedy goes down. Well, both men were going for it, and McGann's got the early breakthrough as Reedy gets the count here, looking to his corner, taking the knee, being sensible. Nods to his corner, gets up at eight, but McGann will be all over him again, looking for a first round finish and through to the semis. What can Reedy do? He throws the jab, he's got to keep his man at range, throws it again, but McGann walking forward, and here they come, the hooks and the uppercuts once more. Reedy under real pressure here, backing up, but McGann keeps firing the shots. He's brought a big crowd here tonight, and Reedy goes to the canvas once more. He's a tough, tough competitor. But McGann's been all over him in this opening round, and it's all over. Dean McGann goes through to the semi-final by way of first round TKO. Final sees George Thorpe, the taller of the two men in the red corner, Kyle Goodwin in the blue. Final instructions before round one. What a start to the round. Both men planting their feet early and throwing the big hooks. Oh, the right hand lands from Thorpe there. And both men throwing for the rafters here, looking to get their opponent out quickly and move on to the semi-final and one step closer to that £1,000 here in the Prizefighter. Good jab from Thorpe there. Just misses with the left. Goodwin comes flying back with his own hooking punches. Looks to work behind the jab once again. Thorpe ducks under the shots and then Goodwin ducks under the replies. It's that sort of bout so far. Looks to come forward again, Goodwin, and press Thorpe against the ropes. Close the gap on the taller man. Oh, takes the right there. Has to give ground. Straight back at Thorpe. Oh, another solid right. And the legs went for a second there for Goodwin. Recovered well. Thorpe pushing forward now, looking to capitalise with the rights to the body. Here comes Goodwin again. Doubling up that jab, Thorpe. And the right hand lands and the left that follows. Goodwin comes straight back at him, but Thorpe stays upright and straight with the punches. Nose bleeding now for Goodwin. Solid shots here from Thorpe with that jab before he throws the right hand. Goodwin backing up, bobbing and weaving. Looks for the big hook, but he's out of range. Thorpe walks him down, throws the stiff jab. Oh, the big right, there's the danger for Goodwin. The jab, the setup for the big right hand. Goodwin bobbing and weaving again, but his hands are low. It's a dangerous game to play, using his reflexes here. But as he does so, he gets caught by the right once more. Last 10 seconds of the round, and Goodwin looks to fire back now, but gets caught again. They both throw the shots, and Goodwin, suddenly the response, caught right at the bell there. Both men fired the big shots, and Goodwin gets the count right at the bell. Well, they both went for it right at the end of round one, and Thorpe came out the better, but both men looking to get their opponent out of there. No need for the judges if you stop your man. So round two after an explosive opening round. And Thorpe probing with the jab once more, as I said, the taller of the two. Goodwin looks to get inside and throw those hooks. They're trading again. What an exciting bout this is. Explosive work from both men. And Thorpe having to duck low now, then come firing back. You feel that one more clean shot from either man could end this bout. Oh, the jab lands cleanly from Thorpe again. Goodwin comes firing in. Oh, and again the right hand as he's firing away. The right hand catches Goodwin clean and he hits canvas once more. That was a solid right hand from Thorpe. And he's back to his feet. He's looking at Harvey Harrow, referee. What a game man he is. What a heart. But it's that right hand of Thorpe during the exchanges. Goodwin goes for broke, which he's got to do now. He looks to land his own big hooks, but twice has been caught by that right hand. And he backs off again. And Harvey Harris going to give Goodwin, I think, another count. He's really feeling it here. He's blinking. Big, big heart, Kyle Goodwin, but he's under real pressure. And Harvey Harris seen enough. He calls it off. Good refereeing there. But it's George Thorpe that goes through to the semi-final, courtesy of the big right hand in round two.
Thank you.
services, Smithy Cottage. Thank you very much for your official sponsors here. Introducing finally into the red corner, wearing black shorts, red trim, all red banding. Please welcome Bailey. And in the blue corner, wearing black shorts, gold skin with all gold banding. Please welcome Reese Ryan.
A final quarter-final sees Bailey Barrington in the red, Reese Ryan in the blue. The taller of the two, the red and black, the black with the red trim, black with the gold trim for Brian, who looks to push the taller Brassington back into his own corner. Brassington turns sweetly. Brian looks for the left hook, the jab in reply from Brassington. Looks to shrug Bailey three and does so. Looks for the little right uppercut, Bailey there. Ducks under the left hand, Brassington brings his own right over the top. Bailey shrugs that off. Pushing forward again, Bailey looks for the left hook to the body. Brassington, good movement, lateral movement, jab, cross. As Brian came in, Brian looks for the big right hand. Brassington slips it again back to the centre of the ring. Ducks under the Bailey hooks. So Bailey looks for the uppercut instead. Under that right hand, looks for his own left hook. Brassington, good movement and technique from both men in this final quarter-final, the fourth bag in this eight-man prize fighter for Great Tipton Promotions. And it's Brian looking to force the issue here in this opening round. Look for the uppercut left and right from Brassington, slipping those replies from Bailey, but Bailey looking to keep the pressure on. Brassington ducking again, double jab from Bailey, staying in the pocket, looking to force Brassington to box at his pace, and it's good work from Brian at the moment. Bailey looking for his left and right in reply to Reese's combinations. It's been a lively opening round, and it's been Reese Brian that's looked to force the issue. Bailey Brassington has committed to his own attacks regularly on the counter as Reese Bryan has forced the issue. That's what's made this so good. Bailey Brassington happy on the counter. Reese Bryan always pushing forward, beautifully setting up round two. So round two, and again Reese Bryan pushing forward consistently, ducks below it Brassington and fires back, waits for Bailey, waits for Reese to commit, and then looks for those counters after he's ducked and moved. Just like that, ducks under the right hand, looks for the left hand counter. So Brassington with the right hand. Bryan, a smile there as he came forward, throws the punches again, but Brassington confident under pressure, calm under pressure, and looks to pick off the counter shots. Again, makes him miss, picks him off with the little right hand. It's subtle stuff. These are two good boxers. You've got the all-action style of Bryan here pushing forward, and Brassington's dealing with it and looking for his own shots cleanly on the counter here. Just like that, that right hand after the combination from Brian. That little left. Brian always busy, he's good to watch. But I'm impressed with the counter style of Brassington here, but he caught the shot there. And Brian pushes forward again. He really is a pressure cooker style of boxer, forcing Brassington to box at his pace. And Brassington ducks and throws the left again. Good, close, solid contest. Great matchmaking here from Craig Tipton for his eight man. Neither of these men you feel will be a handful for whoever they get. The left and then the big right from Brassington. Planted his feet there. Looking to stand and trade now with Rhys Bryan. Turns his man, throws his own left and right and lands with that left hook. It really is the work rate of Bryan against the accuracy of Brassington as we go into this third and final round. Round three, this for a place in the semi-final, the last place in the semi-final, the fourth man. And again, Bryan pushes forward, throws the right, then the left hook. Busy, busy, busy. That's what's made this such a good bout. Brassington forced to duck and dive and pick his counters, but he does that well. Really enjoyed this quarter-final. Two very good young boxers in there. Bryan pushing forward, you can hear the corner say on him now. Brassington has remained composed, he's kept his shape, his discipline against a live wire of a boxer in Rhys Bryan. Oh, good shots there from Bryan, looks to back Brassington up once more. Looks for the short right. Brassington responds, throws his own right hand, the crowd loving this, listen to them. Oh, this is could have been a final for me, these two young men. Real quality from both. One of them's going to be disappointed to not make at least that semi-final. That's the luck of the draw, that these two are meeting each other now because they are so good. Oh, nice shot on the counter from Brassington. That's what he's done across these three rounds. Does so again as Bryan comes in. Bryan drops his own hands. He's got to be careful because Brassington is so accurate. As he comes up with that left hand again after that bobbing and weaving style. Oh, nice combination on the counter again from the red corner. Ducks under that shot, throws the left hand. For me, that's just the subtle difference between the two. If I have to go for one man, it's the accuracy of the combinations on the counter from Brassington against a real live wire. Let's see how the judges go. Yes, Brassington, the counterwork. Bryan, very good in defeat there. Very modest, but what a win. And this man's going to be tough in that semi-final.
White trim and white banding, please.
Two fights away from £1,000. Alex Cox in the red corner, Dean McGann in the blue. Round one of three for a place in the final. The southpaw stance of Alex Cox. Boxed very cleverly in his quarter final, but he's against the explosive punching of Dean McGann, who took out his opponent in the opening round of his quarter final. And Cox responds. As I said, Cox boxed very smartly in his quarter final, used his jab to make his opponent tuck up, then work the body. But Dean McGann used his footwork and explosive punching to open up his opponent and stop him in the first. And already he's looking to put Cox under pressure here. They touch gloves. Jab there from McGann. Cox again, he likes to stay in the pocket, use his mobility and then pick off his shots. But it's a dangerous game against the heavy hitting McGann here. McGann doubling the jab, then the right, looking to back Cox up. And that's what he does, and then he gets the combinations working. In his quarter final, it was a beautiful right uppercut, left hook that started the damage, and here he is again, throwing these hooks and uppercuts. And I love the way he creates the space, he moves to the side, lateral movement, shifts the balance, shifts the angles of attack. Cox, clever boxer, and he's got to be in this bout, calling McGann on. There's the confidence we saw in his quarter final. Oh, already a riveting opening round. What a contest this is proving, this eight-man prize fighter. And again, McCann looking for those short hooks and uppercuts that he throws so well. Looks to keep it close and looks to keep Cox under pressure. And he's doing a good job, but there again, there's the accuracy of Cox, who doesn't mind being in the pocket. And listen to the crowd as Cox suddenly turns it on McCann. Right at the bell there. What an opening round. So Cox not frightened of the power of McGann, and at times himself opened up and threw his own combinations, especially at the end of that opening round, spun McGann and worked that combination. It sets up a beautiful second here in our first semi-final. They touch gloves. Stiff jab from McGann, bobbing and weaving from Cox. He doesn't mind staying there, so he's in range for his own shots. Very confident young man. There's his own left right back. You can see they're planting their feet here. The shots are coming in with venom. McGann likes to work close range and get the shots going, but Cox showed at the end of the first he's not frightened of mixing it. McGann throwing those hooks, but Cox slipping under them. Looks for the uppercut instead, and then the hook to the body. Uses the shoulder to put Cox against the ropes. Cox steps back, throws the left. McGann straight back into him, not giving him any room there. Pressure fighter, likes it close, likes to work in close and on the inside. Cox, that little bob and weave from that southpaw stance, throws the right to the head, the left to the body. Good stiff left to the face of McGann. McGann works the right to the body, then the left hook. Doubles up his own right, Cox. They spin, good footwork, both men. Excellent bout so far. Uppercut hook, it worked for him in the quarter final. McGann looking for that combination again. It's something you drill, and you drill so that it just works for you. But the left hook landed cleanly twice there from Cox. He's such a danger. The uppercut for McGann. Oh, this second round really bursting into life here. Listen to the crowd, they know it. It's these two. Look for those knockout blows. And McGann really pushing forward, but the footwork of Cox gets him out of trouble. Oh, the uppercut lands cleanly for McGann. He throws that punch so well. Cox takes it, throws his own straight left in the last 10 seconds, steps off the center, uses the angles himself. Great footwork from both men as well. Two down, just one to go. Swelling under the left eye of Alex Cox. Remember, he might have to have another bout after this in the final. And McGann, the corner, showing him they like the way they've drilled the way he throws those hooks. And they're saying, get those hooks in, the uppercuts in, tight and close. Third and final round for a place in the final and a shot at £1,000. And again, look how quickly McGann closes the gap to look for those hooks and uppercuts. Cox working to the body. Classic matchup between these two, and both men so good at stepping off the line, working the angles. Non-stop action, superb cardio as this is their second bout as well. Sixth round for Cox, the fourth for McGann, and that's accuracy from Cox there with that combination. That eye has got a mouse under it, that left eye. It's not bothering Cox, but he can't afford to take any more damage with potentially a final coming up if he gets the nod here. And that's a great right hand from him as McGann looks to come in. Oh, and the left. Good moments here from Alex Cox. Dean McGann, though, always in your face, throwing those hooks and uppercuts. But Cox is accurate on the counter. Left hook again from McGann. Pushing forward, the crowd chanting now. Cox drops the hands as he did in the quarterfinal. McGann continues to throw these combinations of short chopping punches. Backing Cox up is a big push from McGann here, and the crowd at fever pitch. What an atmosphere for this prize fighter. And McGann has really dug deep here to keep the pressure on Alex Cox, who breathes heavily. And what happens? McGann just comes straight back in at him. He's really made the effort here in this third round. He took that combination from Cox, and from that point has thrown shot after shot. Good footwork from Cox. But from about a third of the way through this third and final round, he's been under real pressure as Dean McGann has really stepped it up. This could be vital in the judging here because it's a good close contest, but McGann has really gone for it in the third, and they both know it's a great bout. Great styles. Has that third round for McGann given him this bout? Yes, the crowd acknowledging a great semi-final. Sportsman there, look. McGann, that third round did it for him. McGann did it. That third round, he dug deep against a very dangerous opponent.
Red trim with red banding. Bailey Barrett.
So our second semi-final sees George Thorpe take on Bailey Brassington for a chance to meet Dean McGann in the final for £1,000. Thorpe in the white shorts with the black trim took out Carl Goodwin in the second round of his quarterfinal with some power punching, straight strong punches, especially the right hand. Bailey Brassington had a real tough contest against the relentless Reese Bryan, but he showed what a good boxer he is on the counter. So again, potentially another great matchup with Thorpe, those straight hard punches, and Brassington so quick on the counter and so accurate on the counter. Another superb matchup here in the Prizefighter. Eight men started. One of these men is going to be one of the last two in that final to meet Dean McGann. And you can see the sharp work already from both these men. Nice footwork. Accurate, clean technique. Again, Bailey Brassington looking to lure George Thorpe onto the shot so he can counter. Thorpe probes with that jab. Brassington again, just little feints, then comes inside. Fast hands, both men, little smile from Brassington. Thorpe again probing behind that jab. What he's doing here is he's not throwing as many shots as he did against Goodwin because he knows that that's what Brassington wants, to slip and counter. So he's playing a cagey game as well, but there again, there's the accuracy of Brassington. When they both opened up, the left hook lands. He's patient, he's willing to wait his time to land those clean shots. Oh, a cagey technical opening round. Thorpe not as busy as he was in his quarterfinal against Goodwin because he knows he's against a very good counterpuncher. Brassington, for his part, has had to initiate occasionally because Thorpe will not give him the opportunities with multiple punches to slip and counter. Intriguing second round setup. Faster pace start from Thorpe here, does throw the double jab and the straight right. Brassington always on the move, always light on his feet, looking to wait for that opportunity when the guards may be down or the shots thrown to land the clean and accurate counter. For his part, Thorpe bobbing and weaving with those shoulders, and when they engage, it's fast and accurate. A little shoulder shove from Brassington to create the gap with Thorpe. The jab to the body, steps away from the response, steps away from the jab cross from Thorpe, and that's what he waits for. Then he'll suddenly step in with a counter when the miss is there. Double jab though from Thorpe, doing a good job of keeping the range. Brassington suddenly steps in and turns counter work into offensive work, fast footwork to close the gap. When he steps in, it's with conviction. Thorpe staying center ring, conserving energy, knowing there might be a third bout here tonight. Nice sharp shots from both men. A real chess match, this one. Two men with good footwork. There's the turn, there's the right hand. That's the counterwork and the accuracy that Brassington really catches the eye with. This is just with that right hand, Thorpe, and then a little three-punch combination from Brassington in reply. Works the body, works the head, turns his man, leans down on him. Slips away from those punches again, two rounds down, one to go. Thorpe not doing a bad job here. He's keeping the range, keeping his shape, keeping his discipline. But this man, Brassington, knows when to turn, when to throw those sharp little counters. third and final round, and this is still a good, close, technical contest. No problems with the cardio, these two men so fit. Oh, but there's the shots coming now, and a little left hook from Brassington. The key shot in those combinations from both men. Thorpe standing his ground, staying in the pocket with his opponent. Told to go again by his corner. Everything at stake now. Nice turn again from Brassington. Light on his toes. Focused. Double jab there from Sharp. Thorpe, but again, Brassington just makes him miss. Thorpe throws that right hand once more. Little feint there from Brassington. Thorpe looked to double up on the jab. Brassington leans down on him, turns again. Always moving, always turning, looking to disorientate his opponent. Both men jab at the same time, sharp and accurate. But there again, there's the movement from Brassington. Just made Thorpe miss. In his previous bout, Thorpe was landing with those and causing all sorts of problems for Goodwin. He's not found it so easy here in the semi-final. Just like that, where Brassington made him miss again, then turns. Ducks and comes in again. Slips that jab once more, Brassington. Slips the right hand. Thorpe continues to walk forward, continues to probe. And there's the patience of Brassington. But when he throws his shot, he lands. That's what catches the eye. It's subtle things. And again, he raises his hands. The first bit of showboating that accentuates his footwork. And Thorpe, for his part, doggedly determined, stayed chasing his man. But look at the body language from both men. Sporting. But look at the body language from Brassington. Look at Thorpe. The body language said it all from both men. What a technical boxer Bailey Brassington is. What a final is going to be set up.
chances of Great Tipton's 8-man draw.
So this is it, the big eight-man prize fighter comes down to the fight final. Dean McGann, Bailey Brassington, £1,000 at stake. Both these boxers had to fight in the semi-finals against quality opposition. Dean McGann took out Alex Cox in a very hard-fought battle by having a wonderful third and final round. It was a very close bout, and just after he was clipped by Cox, McGann went for the rest of the third round on the inside, like he's trying to do to Bailey Brassington now, and kept working the hooks and uppercuts. For his part, Bailey Brassington took on George Thorpe, who was very accurate in his quarter-final. And again, the superb counterboxing of Brassington. That footwork we just saw there saw him through. So these two men deserve to be in the final. They took out two quality opponents in their semi. And this is a perfect match of styles here. The forward foot, hooking and uppercutting of Dean McGann against the mobility and the counterpunching of Bailey Brassington. The prize fighter final. And again, you can see how quickly McGann comes in. But look at the way Brassington uses his footwork. Dug the left hook into the body. And for me, the speed of that footwork from both men is going to be vital here. If McGann can get inside and rough up Brassington, prevent that silky style, get in close, work those bombs, those hooks and uppercuts that eventually took their toll on Alex Cox. There's Brassington again, he's patient, he waits his moments. And there's that footwork that's got him out of trouble in his quarter-final and his semi-final. And there's the counter-punch, the little left hook, ducks under that right hand. McGann will continue to hunt, will continue to push forward. But possibly against the most elusive opponent he's faced tonight. So round one down, very close. McGann listening to his corner there, and Bailey Brassington here. That mobility, that footwork, and looking for the counter against a dangerous puncher. Two of three. You heard the corner say, come on Bailey, we've got to move. That's their tactic. Brassington has moved all night. He's been mobile, he's been accurate, he's been hard to hit clean. But he's got his biggest test in the man that's managed to catch up and slow down his two previous opponents in Dean McGann. Eventually caught up with them, but he's having real problems here with the footwork, the movement, the angles of Brassington. Hear the crowd, Dino shouting. They like the style of this man, the all-action style, the rolling and throwing as he gets in. But there's what he's got to face, the accuracy on the counter from Brassington, who's constantly on the move, an elusive moving target for all three of his opponents tonight. Thinking man's boxer Brassington throws the jab out, throws the cross, turns again. Every time that McGann looks to get set to throw those vicious hooks and uppercuts, Brassington's on his bike. man looks to his corner, comes forward, rolls the shoulders, and then Brassington throws the punch just before McGann sets himself. And then turns his man, throws the left hook. McGann just bites on the gum shield, comes forward again, looks for that uppercut that served him well in previous bouts. Brassington just turns him away. McGann straight back on him. Brassington ducks, turns, looks for the right to the body, then the left to the body, steps away again at the end of round two, punches the air. One more round between these two men here. The eight-man prize fighter. One round away from that prize money. Eight started, two are here. One will take the cash. Nice sportsmanship, as there has been all night here. It's been a wonderful tournament, wonderful atmosphere, great crowd. And the final 2 minutes of the Prizefighter, and just like he did in the third of the previous bout, McGann finds a spring in his step to force the issue. But Brassington looks fresh as well. McGann bobbing and weaving, but Brassington lands with the left. It's been the accuracy of this young man. It's been a joy in this eight man, and here he goes again. And then the elusiveness in response defensively. McGann pushes forward again. He's got a real engine, this man, hasn't he? And you can see why he gets a following. He's all action, and that's why you hear the shouts, Dina. But look at this, as Brassington starts to open up with the combinations, head and body. Jab from both men, and then Brassington beginning to open up now for the first time. It's his ninth round, and now he starts to open up. I think you can see the end in sight here. You can see the goal in sight. And just starting to open up. Clip with the left, though, because McGann never stops, and he did clip Brassington with that left. Looking to work the right to the body. Brassington looks to turn him. Little look to his corner. And Brassington slips again. We're inside the final seconds of this bout. I've got a feeling Bailey Brassington is going to go all the way with that silky style against his toughest test tonight, the all-action style of Dino McGann. And they have great sportsmanship, but you can see what Brassington thinks. Excellent final, superb tournament. Yes, Craig Tipton, marvellous Prizefighter tournament. Quality boxing tonight. Brassington takes it. He takes it. Real talent there. Dean McGann, very sporting. But what a competition. What a young man. What a performance over nine rounds. And you can see what it means to him. Worthy winner there, Bailey Brassington, of a fantastic eight-man tournament. And that man there pushed him all the way in this final, Dean McGann. What a great way to end a superb tournament and an excellent evening of boxing.